conditions as they are, I'd suggest you take a set of full wets. intermediate tyres are your best bet in the current conditions.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are a McLaren, Button, and Kimi Ra-
Hey, looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
Thank you.
It's late in the evening here in Singapore and it's time for qualifying, so settle down and enjoy the action. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres as they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
The grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are a McLaren, Rosberg, and Lewis Hamilton. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
How are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
Hello and welcome one and all to the shining streets of Singapore. Can you believe we've been coming here for nearly a decade now? It feels like only yesterday that Felipe Massa was dragging his fuel hose down the pit lane in that eventful opening race. And in a Grand Prix won from pole position more often than not, will we see a new victor crowned today? Situated just 88 miles north of the equator, this 3.5 mile circuit is hot, it's humid, and is an incredible test for the drivers as they try to fight their cars around the bumps and in between the barriers. 23 corners take us twice over the bay to complete a single lap of this unique racetrack. The view is spectacular, the heat is unbearable. The race should be incredible. Anthony Davidson is alongside me in the commentary box this evening. And big race this one, a real test of endurance. Sounds right up your alley. Wouldn't you just love to be down there on the grid right now?
You know what, Crofty? I'm pretty happy to be up here in my air conditioning, thank you, right now. I can't stress just how difficult these conditions can be, especially when you consider it's the longest race on the calendar in terms of time. It's also one of those races where you have to remember to keep drinking, or there's a real risk of dehydration. Just like we saw with young Kevin Magnussen a couple of years ago, don't forget. We mentioned the bumps as well. Take a look at the onboards if you get a chance during this race. The movement in the suspension and the chassis is just incredible. And it's lots of hard work to wrestle the car around the lap here.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's McLaren in pole position then, with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Vettel, Kimi Raikkonen and Button, Ricciardo, Verstappen, Perez and Nico Hülkenberg, Sainz, Grosjean, Valtteri Bottas and Kvyat, Massa, Gutierrez, Rio Haryanto and Pascal Wehrlein, Ericsson and Magnussen. Felipe Nasser and Jolyon Palmer rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Temperature, please. Get some movement to the excess fuel. We have extra fuel to burn.
Reserve to get through.
tons of fuel remaining. There's extra weight on the car, and we have a lot of spare fuel we can burn. There's 8 laps of fuel remaining. We're really overfueled right now. We have only in reserve to get through.
Thank you.
fastest laps of the race. superb all season and you've got your reward. You are the Drivers' World Champion. Congratulations.
There were questions at the start of the season as to whether this package could really go all the way. But there's no question anymore. What a special year it's been. And here they are now. The new Formula One World Drivers' Champion. Brilliant stuff from McLaren today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And look at that, they're making their way out onto the podium now. Great race from the McLaren team, and I'm really happy to see them there on the top step of the podium. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. We also crown a new champion today, as their lead at the top is now an insurmountable one. What a great year it's been for Formula One. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Oh, well, I'm a bit spoilt for choice, Crofty. My instinct says Valtteri Bottas, and looking down the field, no one really jumps out at me to make me change my mind.
On to the constructors then. McLaren move further clear at the top. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time. This weekend, we're at Kuala Lumpur for the Malaysia Grand Prix, and we're starting off with today's practice session. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the action. So, Anthony, lots to do, of course, in these sessions, lots of programs to run. What are you looking for when you jump in the car for free practice?
Well, you have basic checks, first of all. You know, is the car working correctly? What the track conditions like? And you'll be chasing that as the session goes on. Things like that. Then you start getting into the nitty-gritty of it all, and they become more like test sessions, where it's all about gathering new data, testing components, tweaking the setup, and so on. So there's only so much actual practice that these drivers need. Most of them will be plenty familiar enough with the track layout, either from previous experience or from the simulator.
These changes made. repairs have set us back a little.